My name's Amy and I'm an English teacher in Cumbria. I'm here to share my journey with you using Merit. So my Year 11s have now done their first mock exam. We did English Language Paper 2 and I was then ready to upload my data after I'd marked the papers. There are two ways that you can upload data onto Merit. You can either input it directly onto the website or you can download their spreadsheet, input the data onto that and re-upload it. I chose the first option simply because it was going to be quicker and more efficient for me. I was really impressed with how intuitive the system was and how easy it was actually to just upload that data. It really didn't take me very long at all. So now that I've uploaded my data, my reports are ready to look at. So let's take a look at what they tell me. I can see is that there is a really handy breakdown of each individual student's marks, which gives me a really good understanding of how they've performed across the paper, but it also gives me a breakdown for each student and their performance against the assessment objectives, which also allows me a slightly different insight into how they've performed. Even better, there's also a colour-coded table and it gives me a really clear overview of the strengths and weaknesses across the students in my class. Within that, it also tells me something about the way that they've performed as a group. So I can tell from this that for question five, on average, we are starting to get into band three for question five, which is exactly where I was targeting them pre-mocks. I found a page that gives me the individual breakdown per student for each of the questions for their mock exam. And what this allows me to do is really get to grips with that personalised data. And there are a couple of things that this tells me straight away that are really useful to know. The first is the breakdown of how students have performed on question four. Some of our students have performed really well on that question and I might not have expected that because I know that this is a difficult question and therefore I might be a bit biased. And that's one of the really important things for me about using Merit is that it gives you that unbiased look at your own data, where you find things that maybe you weren't expecting, even if they're nice things, such as students have done better than you might have expected them to do. And what's really interesting here is that despite my positive feelings about question four and the way that some students have performed, you can clearly see that for my class, question four is probably the weakest question. To find out who to target, I have clicked on students at the top left on the screen, and that gives me reports for each student. It's not taken me long at all to go through those, and all of the information's organised there for me, which is really helpful and has saved me a lot of time. This student breakdown also makes it really easy to see who needs which specific intervention and who needs specific input in certain areas, which is also really helpful. So now I've got my list together of who I'm going to be targeting and what I'm specifically going to be looking at with them. So there's two things really that I've identified and written down in my notebook. The first is that I'll be doing some interventions with anyone that's getting below 9 marks on question 4, and then that might then be broken down into why they've done that, whether it's a question misconception or whether it's a timing issue. I'm then going to also look at those students who are in band 2 for AO6 on question 5. So that's the assessment objective that looks at spelling, punctuation and grammar. And the minimum I would expect my class to be at is 9 out of 16 for that question and that assessment objective. So anyone that is below, that's in band 2, I will do some specific work with and work on the range of punctuation that they use. So all in all, this has taken me about an hour or so to input my data and then look at it in detail and be able to plan what I'm going to do on the back of that data. For me, that's the real strength of Merit, because it doesn't I don't waste my time inputting data. What I'm able to do is do that really quickly, really efficiently, and then use my time to do the bit that really makes the difference, which is the planning off the back of that data. In the past, when I've marked mocks, it's been more of a gut reaction on as to how students have done and what I need to do. This breaks it down for me in a way that is removes sort of any bias that I might have or any wrong gut instincts based on that data. So when the rest of the department put their marks up, I can have a look at how my students have done in comparison to the rest of the school. And that level of data, I think, is really important, because what you'll be able to do as a department is identify where your strengths are as a team and share best practice. So I feel like now I've got a really clear plan together for intervention based on this mock exam series, which has been really helpful for me to know what to improve with my teaching and where to focus my time. And importantly, I've been able to use that time to think about those areas, because it's all well and good having data. You've then got to use it to have some impact with students and their performance, and merit has allowed me to do that.